ninth pick in the 1998 NBA draft, Dirk Nowitzki from Würzburg, Germany.
Bradley Boston, the receiver, comes up shooting, and he's got his first complete field goal.
Nowitzki with eight, turns, leans, right-hander is good at it.
Today is a monumental moment in Dallas Mavericks history. Born from the glories of a legendary career, today we immortalize a game-changing champion with a permanent place for his immortal shot.
46 points.
Nowitzki from way down low. 3 points.
Nowitzki elevating his status amongst the NBA's greats.
Most valuable player award to Dirk Nowitzki.
Today, we are all here for one, Dirk Nowitzki. Welcome to the American Airlines Center and the All for One unveiling ceremony.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Mavs TV voice Mark Folliwell, and what a great day it is to be in MFFL. Dirk was in his second year in the NBA when I started working on the Mavericks radio broadcast. It was a privilege to call so many of his games on Mavs radio and TV broadcast over the remainder of those seasons. And it's an indescribable honor to take part in this one-of-a-kind day in the history of the Dallas Mavericks. If you're with us here on the South Plaza on this cold Christmas morning, watching inside the American Airlines Center, or if you're watching online in North Texas, in Würzburg, Germany, or anywhere else around the globe, I know how much you've waited for this day, and you'll see very soon what you came here to see or are watching to see. Before we get started, there are a number of dignitaries that are here with us today that I'd like to recognize, including Dallas Mavericks CEO Cent Marshall, Dallas Mavericks General Manager Nico Harrison, Dallas Mavericks Vice President of Basketball Operations, one of Dirk's longtime teammates, Michael Finley. Here with us today is the widow of original Dallas Mavericks owner, Mr. C, Don Carter, Ms. Linda Carter. Dirk's mentor, coach, teacher, confidant, and everything else, Holger Geschwender. I see today that we have with us some of Dirk's longtime teammates. The Matrix, Sean Marion is here, and Devin Harris. And also here representing the city of Dallas, we have members of the Dallas City Council. In April 2019, when Dirk Nowitzki retired after 21 seasons with the Dallas Mavericks, I said then that as the play-by-play guy, I know all of the numbers, the milestones, and the achievements in Dirk's career. Sports needs those numbers for context as we tell the story of Dirk Nowitzki now and to future generations of MFFLs. Those achievements are as impressive today as they were when we reflected on them 3.5 years ago. Sixth in NBA history in scoring with 31,560 points. The only player to spend 21 seasons with one franchise. The highest scoring foreign-born player in NBA history. The Mavericks' all-time leader in points, games, rebounds, block shots, field goals, three-pointers, and free throws. A 14-time NBA All-Star, a 12-time All-NBA selection, a winner of the NBA's Most Valuable Player Award, a winner of the Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award. And there's one other thing I should probably mention, an NBA champion in 2011. But as we know, Dirk's contributions to the Mavericks, the sports fans in North Texas and all over the world, and to the game of basketball are defined through far more than just numbers. The impact that we measure on the floor in stats, we measure off the floor, and Dirk's passion to advocate for the game of basketball globally. For Dirk's enthusiasm for being an ambassador and representative for North Texas. By the time, energy, and resources that Dirk, his wife Jessica, and the Dirk Nowitzki Foundation have invested in programs to uplift underserved communities and individuals, and in the smiles that we saw over the years on a lot of children's faces. Dirk spoke earlier this year at his Jersey retirement about the pillars that helped build and support his career. But of course, Dirk himself is a pillar of this franchise and this community. It's why a street that is just a few feet away from us has been renamed Nowitzki Way. It's why that jersey with the number 41 now hangs in the rafters inside at the American Airlines Center. And it's why in a few minutes we'll unveil a statue that not only further immortalizes Dirk's place in the history of the Dallas Mavericks and the game of basketball, but also an iconic shot that will forever be connected to its creator. An individual who passed the ball to Dirk for many of those iconic one-legged fadeaways has some memories to share about Dirk and his famous shot. So please welcome, joining us now, a 2011 NBA champion, a Naismith Memorial Basketball Hall of Famer, and the current head coach of the Dallas Mavericks. Give it up, please, for Jason Kidd. A trumpet fanfare. How about that, Jay?
On a nice, warm day.
So, Jason, just a few short questions in your time here before you go back to get ready for today's game with the Lakers. How special is it for you to be here, to see some of your past championship teammates, and to be here to honor Dirk on this very special day?
Well, it's incredible to be here on Christmas, to be able to see this gift that is going to be an iconic jump shot that you worked on with Holger, that you tried to teach me to breathe through my eyes and use my two fingers, but I just couldn't get the breathing right. But it's incredible to be here again. One more stop, the Hall of Fame. But when you talk about history, this beautiful art piece will be here forever, and you deserve it. So do we as teammates.
All right, so I want to ask a question about the shot. When you started seeing Dirk really use the shot, the one-legged fadeaway, in games, it was such an integral part that we all remember of the run for the championship. What did you think when you first started seeing Dirk implement the one-legged fadeaway?
I just didn't think he was athletic. but no, it's a shot, when you talk about Kareem, something that could never be blocked. Now you have everyone trying to do it in this league, and so it just shows that you did the right thing at the right time.
Jason, when you spoke the night of the jersey retirement ceremony, you were here. We talked about the statue a little bit that night. What have you thought ever since that night and have been thinking about the statue?
Well, the statue is beautiful. They got it right. It's history. It's a beautiful art piece. But there is one thing that's missing. We're going to have to go to McDonald's or something to put the little burgers that carried you.
Thanks so much, Mavericks head coach Jason Kidd.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Speaking of the statue, let's check out a video about the making of the Dirk Nowitzki statue.
When I first learned about being a statue was probably in my last game of my career. Mark took the mic and said,
"And I'll promise you, we will put the biggest, most badass statue ever. And we'll put it right in front of the arena."
And it has to be big because it takes us, and everything is bigger in Texas.
When we walk in, you know, it's amazing because you have a certain imagination, you know, but seeing it in reality, you know, it's unbelievable.
We chose the one-leg fadeaway shot. Holger taught me everything about the shot that I know, and this is, I think, a perfect reflection of what we've worked on for so long.
The signature shot, Dirk invented more or less into the NBA to improve the game.
James falling away, got it.
Doncic, the turnaround.
Jokic, fade away.
Durant off the one leg.
He didn't hit him with the dirt.
The idea is to show it as right as possible. You know, and Omri was really great listening, you know, and we're working on it since, 2 years?
We started with the understanding of what the fadeaway shot meaning on the human anatomy, because we are provide the expression of the human anatomy into the metal. We've mainly to focus on elimination of a gravity. You do all the above with a very good crew of artists that you train, and they become master themselves.
We did a bunch of drawings and signings and talking about angle and all that stuff. Yeah, but hey, now we have to make the final decision because it should be in Dallas soon.
You want to adapt every story to its contents and the personality and the history, and it's all boiled down into a one piece of bronze that doesn't move forever. This is how it's going to look like, the white bronze. It's going to be like white gold, and then we're going to bring it to a vivid color. It will be sparkly with the pigments and translucency, like you'll see the metal through the pigments. And in the sun, it will be like the golden piece. And 500 years from now, people will come and will ask why. It will give them a glimpse of this youngster who migrated from Germany to the United States that leave his mark on the human history.
To me and to the people in Dallas, loyalty never fades.
Statues are erected to commemorate a notable or famous person. And as you can tell from the video, the statue is a work of art. The history of depicting athletes in art through paintings, drawings, and engravings goes back as far as 5,000 years ago. In ancient Greece, artists were making sculptures and statues of athletes in the 5th century BC. A famous sports writer, the late Frank DeFord, stated on NPR a few years ago that statues of athletes are remembrances of good things past. We're fortunate to have a premier artist and sculptor to commemorate this history that is so important to everyone who has watched and enjoyed Dirk's career. You saw him in the video. He's here today for the All for One unveiling and to present this wonderful piece of art as a gift to the city of Dallas that will be here for 500 years. A designer and sculptor of numerous athletes among his long list of commissioned works. A round of applause, please, for Mr. Omri Amrani. The man who made the promise that we saw on the story of the statue video is, of course, with us here today. We know from his comments back in April of 2019 and all through Dirk's time here, how much he respects and admires Dirk and is so excited for this day to be here. Please welcome everyone, Mavs Governor Mark Cuban.
Dirty. I was gonna come up here and say all the things I feel about you and everything out of my heart. And then I realized I did it the day you retired. I did it when we named Nowitzki Way. I did it for your jersey retirement. I mean, is there going to be a garden, you know, Nowitzki Garden? Or... But I did make you a promise. And it's a promise that it gives me joy to deliver on because you earned it. You earned it for every fan of the Dallas Mavericks. You earned it for every fan of Dirk Nowitzki. So without further ado, come on up, bring Max up, and let's do this. Okay, we're gonna do a countdown. You all ready? Yeah. We're gonna start with three. Three, two, one, bam! We'll be right back.
That thing is huge. Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you, guys. I want to say thank you to the city council for coming today and for all the support throughout my career. I really appreciate it. When I think of the first guy that I want to thank, I think of loyalty, what this guy has done for me during my career and after my career with my last game, with the jersey retirement, and now this amazing piece. Thanks, Mark, for everything you've done for me and my family. Well, Mark had the vision and the idea for this, and of course we needed somebody to follow through and make this happen. So I want to thank Holger, my mentor, for being in charge of this, and also, more importantly, Laura Beth and her team. This has been an incredible project for a couple of years, and I know you guys worked so hard, and it's been the installment here this week. It's been super cold out, and the team was out here all night. So thank you guys for making this happen. Then we needed a guy to build this thing. I know Holger in his dreams thought he could do it, but we needed actually a professional, and I've seen some of these guys work around the cities, around other arenas, and we were thrilled when he came on board. And it was a great pleasure to work with Omri the last 2 years and his staff. So thank you so much for being here today and for this amazing piece. What would this day, this huge honor be without having my family here? So. Thank you guys for coming all this way, for all the support. And this is also for you guys. I think what makes this so special is we have three generations of Nowitzkis here today, and this thing will be here long after we are gone and other generations come here and be proud. So thank you guys. I want to thank all my my ex-teammates, of course, that and JK, thanks for the nice words. All my ex-teammates and the Mavs staff. Somewhere I've been with you guys for over 20 years. You guys, this is also for you. Without this, I wouldn't have been able to do all this. So thank you guys. Merry Christmas. Thank you guys for sharing your Christmas morning with us and with me. It means a ton. I'm truly humbled, and I'm gonna leave you guys with the motto. It says there on the side under my name, on the side on the base, and it is actually 21 letters for 21 years, and I think it sums up my career here for the Dallas Mavericks perfectly. And it says, "Loyalty never fades away." Thank you.
It's beautiful. Thanks to everyone who's been with us here today for the All for One unveiling outside the American Airlines Center, watching inside the arena, or if you're watching online around the world. Again, at the base of the statue, you heard Dirk say it. He chose those words, "Loyalty never fades away." Thank you, Dirk, for your loyalty to the Mavs and to Dallas. And thanks to all the MFFLs that have been so loyal to Dirk and to this franchise over the years. Enjoy the rest of your holiday, and especially the Mavs game coming up here in just a little bit against the Lakers. Thanks and good morning.